Only lost two games in the Big East, they'll be tough up there.
UConn has a history of playing Syracuse very strong, and they hope that they can continue that tonight, although this is a different kind of Syracuse basketball team. We'll have highlights coming up tonight at 11. Ken Strayhorn reporting live on the Star Cam from the Carrier Dome in Syracuse. Bob?
Okay, Ken, I imagine Jim Calhoun got the Huskies at
1, and you know you're going to get beat sometime, but you don't expect to win in... somewhere after Scotty scores the first layup after 5 seconds, the game might have been over, and that's a devastating loss for us. And had a 5-hour bus ride to Syracuse to think about it on top of it. So, you know, that's part of basketball, though. You're going to have some adversity, you're going to have some good times, and that certainly was a bad time. But we're here, ready to play Syracuse.
You're a marathon man. That's as quick as I've ever seen you go off the floor.
Well, you know, I tried to wait for the kids, and they had to pass by me, which is probably, as tough as the afternoon was, that might have been the toughest part of all.
All right, Danielle Marshall, you're not sure right now whether he will play or at least start. How good is he? And he's struggling a little bit with this injury.
Well, the good news is that not structurally we don't see anything at all, just maybe a strain, a bruise onto his, with a tendon attached to the fibula in his bone, but simply... You know, Danielle Marshall is from a standpoint of futuristically, he's going to be a great basketball player. Right now, he's a pretty darn good one, and you know, we're really happy to have him with us. If he really can't go tonight, and we see he's struggling early, we're going to take him out, assuming that he's going to start. Or we may just bring him off the bench, see how he feels once the adrenaline gets going. But John Amas, I think he's going to be a very special basketball player.
I know all the coaches love the road. How about the aura of this place?
Well, you know, I personally think it's a great place to play basketball. I really do. I think that everybody talks about the vastness of it, but when you put 30,000 mm-hmm. people in here, it's not very vast at all. Matter of fact, it's kind of intimate in many, many ways, and you can hear the guy in section 301 even, so that tells you it's a real basketball place.
Well, Jimmy, thanks for dropping by. This is relaxed, as you'll see Jim Calhoun all evening, and now we'll throw it back to SportsCenter.
Yeah. And we'll see you guys in just a bit. Next here on SportsCenter.
ESPN presents NCAA basketball from the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York. It's the 10th-ranked Huskies of Connecticut and the 13th-ranked Orangemen of Syracuse in a Big East battle. Hello once again, everyone, and welcome to another Big Monday. John Saunders along with Jim Valvano. This is the battle for first place in the Big East, but Jim, Syracuse is a team who came back from a big deficit. Connecticut is a team that got clobbered the last
time
out.
John, I have stats everywhere. Stats everywhere you look. All right, here we go. Since 87-88, Jim Calhoun's team has lost twice, two other times by 20 points or more. You know if they've done the next game, John? They've won. They beat Pittsburgh, they beat Boston College. Okay, so you know they're going to come back. Calhoun's in the locker room telling we got to get him. On the other hand, they've only won, that is Connecticut, two times in the last 10 at Syracuse. And Syracuse is 30-1 in their last 31 games. So what does that tell you? That tells you it's going to be a close ball game. Syracuse probably has the edge.
I got one more for you. Syracuse has won 13 in a row over nationally ranked teams at the Carrier Dome. So it should be interesting. Some other stories.
Syracuse University. Connecticut comes in tonight, number one in the Big East, but it is up for grabs. A victory by Syracuse, and they would be tied. Hello, everybody. Gary Thorne, Bill Raftery, and welcome. For the University of Connecticut, Raft, they are coming off their worst loss since the 84-85 season. 33 points they lost mm-hmm. to St. John's. They've got to come back, and they're going to have to do it tonight, maybe without one of their stars.
Well, I don't think Danielle Marshall will be playing, according to the coaches. He may get in, but he will not start. Hopefully, he will be all right. But it's going to be a struggle defensively. A great shot blocker.
What do we look for from Syracuse?
Well, when you think of Syracuse, it's always Johnson, but Moten, maybe Sir Lawrence of Syracuse. And I'll tell you how smart the coaches in the Big East are. They didn't vote him on their first team all rookie. He's an outstanding talent that can penetrate. He's got a flair. He's a mature youngster, finds people, not afraid to take big shots.
And these are two of the top 20 teams in the country coming together here tonight and at a place that has drawn over 5 million people. And they'll have over 30,000 on hand here tonight. We're set to go. Syracuse and UConn.
CAA Basketball is brought to you by...
Come on, Big Monday here at ESPN, and what a matchup. Number 10, Jim Calhoun. That's where Connecticut's ranked in the AP poll that came out this afternoon in his sixth year. And there you see the numbers for him against Connecticut, against Syracuse, since he's been coaching there. His lineup tonight will be a lineup he's used most often this season. Fair, however, will be starting. And their leading scorer right there, Chris Smith, almost 23 points a game. For Jim Boeheim, Syracuse is now ranked 13th on the poll today. And for him, the coach of the year last season, and he may get it again. And he's got the numbers against Connecticut. It'll be Adrian Autry, 14 points and a team-leading 36 assists. The sophomore will be on the floor. This man is not starting, ref.
It's tragic, really, but it's better to be sure his career is going to be a great one. I think we'll see a little. It was his decision, by the way. The doctors cleared him. X-rays were fine.
Syracuse will control, and Autry's got the basketball, and we'll be saying that a lot tonight, as he will do a lot of setup work for the Orange Men of Syracuse.
UConn been a man.
And the fans stand and in rhythmic applause until Syracuse scores their first field goal, one of the traditions here. Mike Hopkins. That's Moten, Lawrence Moten, who may be the rookie of the year everywhere before it's said and done. That's for three, and that's not in. Rebound. Sion. Moten. Three. Get it. One for two. Freshman averaging 19 a game. And the pushing foul will be called underneath on Dave Sion.
And that tells you something. They're looking for it. The kick from the inside by Johnson out to Moten, and the rookie responding. Look at those improvements. Early on, they disdained its use.
This is a peripheral team, Syracuse, offensively. They need to shoot from outside. That's what Jim Boeheim thought at the beginning of the season, and he's been able to get it.
Well, the 2-3 now on the out-of-bounds. There are holes in it, baseline and in the three-second lane.
That's for three, no good. Right pass underneath.
And a fair cut by Brian.
Fair gets the two.
A 2-2-1.
And our first imitation of Keats for the night.
You know, incidentally, Gary, we used to do this at Signal Hall, stand until we made a basket, but it took so long they gave up on it.
Zag had it knocked away. Hopkins has got it. And both teams are shooting from three-point range here. That's where all the attempts have come from, except for the basket put up by Connecticut. Fair, Brian Fair, the freshman, getting the start tonight. He's the one who put that in for Connecticut out of bounds. It will stay for the Orange Men.
Jimmy Boeheim felt rebounding was the essential ingredient if they were going to win tonight. And incidentally, Calhoun out officiating early there.
Yes, Johnson had it blocked underneath. Good block by Torino Walker that time. Sellers gets it. Sigh off the rebound. Look at him run. Autry dumps it off. They've got Moten. Double clutch. Moten tipped. But he can't control the second rebound. Sellers had the rebound. Smith quickly. Oh. Brian Fair going in, and it is a blocking foul.
Now, of all the teams you'll see in the country, they may throw the longest passes, whether it's on the break or cross court. That's a half-court chest pass. The response by Burrell and Fair, very aggressive, both times going to the goal on cuts.
And that's two personal fouls now on Dave Sion, their junior at center. That could add up in a hurry. And Fair is starting out big time in a start here as he gets one from the line.
Oh, they're not afraid to bring Conrad McCray in, who provides some great shot-blocking ability and also has improved his low-post offense.
Fair has come off the bench in every game this season, but this is the first start that he's had for Connecticut.
And their first lineup change of the year. So Jimmy pretty set in his ways.
He's used him and wishes he had him in for tonight's game, but Fair's giving him a great start here with UConn up 4-3.
That is a real simple offense. High-low, they open up, they'll post up Autry and Johnson down low to take advantage.
Autry, he had the advantage on Smith as he took him down low that time, but couldn't put it in. Smith brings it up. Fair. Fireside. Three. Yes!
They've been waiting for him to get on fire. Again, deployment. Setting up wide, able to utilize the floor. Very difficult to defend.
Ryan Fair, the freshman out of Phoenix. At least doing everything. Three-point shots, layup, steals the ball. Sellers dishes to Smith for three. And Syracuse will control the boards.
Hold on.
Hello. David Johnson.
Hello to Johnson City, the Morgan City. It'll be Johnson City the way he's playing, huh?
Their leading scorer on over 20 points a game, the senior Dave Johnson stuffs that one home.
Said his mom can't wait to see these Monday night games.
No wonder.
That's right, lighting it up for
her. UConn up by two. The fans getting into it big time here.
There's that trap. Makes you take a quicker shot. Well, that'll defuse the audience, huh?
Scotty Burrell, the junior. He's averaging 17 a game. And a lot of big buckets like that. Hopkins goes the middle. He got hauled down by Burrell.
Well, Michael known for a little softer touch than that as it caroms to the foul line, the giveaway. But Scotty, the maturity to find the hole in the trap as Burrell made the cut and quieted the audience here.
Burrell called on the personal foul. That will be his first. Syracuse going to the free throw line in the person of Mike Hopkins.
How about these crowds they get with a 30,000? Unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
I guess there's a lot of alternates, too, here.
12 decisions. A lot, yeah. Tickets. Everyone that came into town, the first thing anybody asked me was, look, doing the game tonight, got any tickets?
This is extraordinary. When it started, people questioned whether you could get live bodies in here. And they have. Of course, Jimmy Boeheim, every year, pounding on the door to the NCAA. This, an unusual year, no superstar, but team basketball.
Hopkins getting one out of two in the steal. Hopkins coming the other way. 9-6 UConn. Fair guarding Hopkins. Syok, the big man underneath. That's for three. UConn will do what they do well, and that's rebound. Morrell came down with it. Smith.
Nice balance.
Big man, Sellers. Pretty tough.
Not bad, and they do need some help. And that's the challenge, I think, for UConn. To bang inside against the outmanned Syracuse people up front.
Connecticut leading the Big East in scoring as a team, 79 points per game. Syracuse is third at 74, knocked out of bounds. Syracuse will hold it in, but UConn's playing the tough defense. And we will get our first timeout with 15:43 left to go in this first half. Great to have you with us at ESPN's Big Monday, Connecticut Syracuse. Connecticut's got the early lead. There's been, of course, a good deal of discussion about off-the-court activities. Conman McRae here at Syracuse has filed suit against the NCAA. Those are the points. ESPN talked with his attorney today. He's asking for $1.35 million for damage to reputation, primarily loss of exposure because he was taken off the playing surface for a while. It's a unique lawsuit in the sense it goes against the NCAA by a player, but not unique in that a lot of players have bought it against their colleges before and have not won. We'll see what happens. Moten gets the two.
Oh, pretty good press. Breaking down the pressure outside by Moten. All of them outside are very good with the bounce. And hey, Gary, I guess there's no precedence in a case like this, you're saying.
No, not for against the NCAA. Players have brought it against colleges before when they've been denied a scholarship because they violated team rules. And most of the courts have had little trouble in denying those cases. We'll see if Conman McRae has any more success. The NCAA will be answering that lawsuit this week, and they say they dispute, of course, all the allegations that have been made. That's what you'd expect to hear at this point.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll see what happens with it.
And zone trying to that. So they're trying to trap and then play a passing lane.
For three, is Fair hot or what?
Well, they said that's what they expected him to do. They were waiting for him to get on track.
He's got 10 points in the basketball game now, including two from the three-pointer. And he's put him on top, 14-8, and even more than that, he has really quieted the Syracuse crowd. Burrell did it once, he's done it twice. Lawrence Moten, the freshman, pass was knocked away by Fair again.
Always trying to punish you with the break. They got away with one, huh?
He had it knocked out of his hands that time.
Autry.
Autry dishes, no room for Hopkins. There's Lawrence Moten. Another three, Autry, and he's got it.
Well, they've got you backed up with the dribble. Hopkins took it to the goal. The dark shirts on the baseline didn't respond to the deep shot.
Autry is now 20 for 42 from three-point range in Big East play.
How about Calhoun on the 4 or 5 hour bus ride? Didn't speak all the way up from New York after the St. John. Every time I see a bus, I get a rash, though.
I can understand
it,
that.
Oh, it usually reminds you of a bad happening on the road.
Millions of miles for you. Smith for three, and they are hot tonight. Both
these teams are gunning it, and that's a bit of a surprise that the percentage is as high as it is for these teams on the floor right now.
I just think Connecticut emotionally upset after that disastrous loss. St. John's just played great and took it to them, and they couldn't counter. So there are ups and downs during the course of the year. Nice cut here by Autry.
Autry likes to go in the lane as well as shoot deep. Hopkins with Walker on him.
You know, Michael should take that, but he's hesitant, trying to blend in.
Johnson. Looking underneath. McRae. Almost an air ball. Just touched the rim on the far side.
A scraper.
Smith. Connecticut forcing the basketball up. 17-11 lead here. Burrell looking underneath. They want the big man.
When they reverse the ball, they're a tough club, and that's what happened.
Sellers.
Side to side, down low. Syracuse can't counter. I think they've got to deny that pass across the top.
Sellers and Walker underneath. Both of them have a real nice touch, and they're putting pressure on at midcourt.
You know, Conrad relies on that jumping. He does not deny the post pass.
Hopkins. Fake Sellers. Misses the two. Walker gets the rebound. A very strong rebounder, Torino Walker. He's averaging over 7 rebounds a game.
And there's the Moten meander after the tough call. The folks up here say after a call, one official on top of it let it go. But the guy I think you spoke so highly of last week.
Danielle Marshall is in the game. He has got a bad knee. Look at that. He has already set a season record, and he's just a freshman. We'll see how he plays here. The knee is an old high school injury that acted up at the end of that loss, the game against St. John's. 33-point loss for Connecticut in that game. Fair could not hang on to him.
You notice those high socks. It's easy for the officials to spot Moten.
Autry for three.
A little quick.
Fair's got a rebound.
Look at the guys running the floor, though.
Marshall was running that time. Johnson got back, knocked it away. Fair's done everything but take tickets here tonight so far.
He's been extraordinary. Of course, stepping up, good opportunity. You know what it does to this team, though? Makes Burrell a forward. There are better clubs sometimes with him down there rebounding than competing.
Burrell right there.
No. No walk.
He tried it.
No walk. No. It wasn't the step with the two pivot foot. The jump stop. Well, it slid on him as he jump stopped. I guess that's what they called it for.
Hopkins comes back the other way.
If you land on the two pivot feet, you can't take that next step. So that's what they call, and you can't really argue with it.
And he had it set and was stuck with it.
I thought he had one later than the other.
That's why we're here and they're officiating.
Fortunately.
Fortunately, yeah. Jody Sylvester, Donnie Gray, and John Clockery are the officials tonight. That's for three. Tapped up by Sellers, no good. Chris Smith missing the three-point attempt. Autry goes to the corner. Three again. Boy, they're all shooting it. Big rebound up and in.
Well, you take long shots. Sometimes it's tough for the defense to put a body on somebody. But, you know, against this zone, you're going to find a corner jump shot if they're patient. They're going to cause the wing people to make decisions.
Johnson getting those two. That's again Brian Fair. He has three three-pointers in this game.
Well, they said he could shoot it. There's a step and a hop, huh?
13 points for Brian Fair, who comes into this game averaging 6 points a game. UConn with a lead, 22-15.
We're willing to.
You want to play a little zone against UConn? You're going to have to cover an awful lot of the floor. Great ball movement. We mentioned deployment. Look at this pass, the dump down, back diagonally across. And when you can ring the bell, as well as Fair has, you're going to create havoc for that zone.
Look at the numbers he's got. His career high is 15 points he had against Texas. He's already got 13 points in this game. 3 three-pointers shot by Brian Fair, who is making his first start.
And pretty fair in a few sports, they tell us, huh?
Boy, I'll tell you, he's a great athlete. We're seeing why they got him on the basketball court.
Well, Valvano goes nuts when you play zone against three-point shooting teams. And this is a good example right here.
Autry knocks it out.
It's tough to come up and make contact. And, of course, the inside people now benefit by all the great deep shooting.
That'll draw that zone out almost backcourt. Chris Smith 22.7 points a game, their leading scorer.
They use it all, Gary. I mean, that's a case in point. Back to half court. Not afraid.
Not afraid to shoot from anywhere either.
Well, you don't shoot with the knee.
Danielle Marshall. He's got a bad knee. You'd never know it by that shot. Comes off the bench and gets 2 points. He's averaging 11 a game.
The press is 2-2-1. Passive. They'll get the ball in the wrong hands, as you notice McCray walked.
Autry. Michael Edwards is out there with him. And that's going to be for three. And what a tremendous move to draw the foul by Lawrence Moten.
Well, Sir Lawrence hiding on the baseline. He absolutely knows that area of the floor, whether he dribbles through and creates for others or finds a hole for himself. And you notice the three-pointer. Now he's in tight, hanging in the air and hiding against that zone. Now get between floors. Hold on and release.
And he double clutched to make sure the foul would be created.
Get the body.
There are the great numbers for him. Outstanding freshman season. Moten is sixth in Big East in scoring.
So you see more of that in D.C. and big cities than you do in Des Moines. They like to shoot with some contact.
Well, he got the contact. Danielle Marshall committed his first foul. He missed the foul shot, however. That's for three again, and that is an air ball. Dice on that one. Torino Walker is way off. That's Johnson, and that's for three and no good. And the deep rebound is Smith. Three-pointers. We're going to pile up some attempts in this game before it's done. Spread it out. Marshall for three.
Over.
And he's over the top. Syracuse will get it.
But they do have opportunities now to get it inside if they're just a little patient, because Jimmy Boeheim's guys are running out on the shooter. All they have to do is flash post.
Take a look at that. That's a lot of three-point attempts right there compared to your two-point shots.
Edwards in thinks offense. Autry on the off guard now.
Smith on him. Autry gets Smith up in the air and gets the two.
Little stronger than Chris. Knows how to post up. Red's got a total game.
Adrian Autry, a sophomore, averaging just under 14 a game. Leads the club with 36 assists. And he's working Smith down low tonight. Ollie Smith.
Now there's the baseline. When they bring Moten, now Johnson, they got to run somebody baseline. Look at his inside passing, this is the outside shooting.
Marshall just lost the basketball that time. We'll get it back at half court. Danielle Marshall. Thank Chris Smith right there. He's the one who knocked it free. Ollie drives the lane and gets undercut. And he'll go to the line.
Nice penetration. And a step late. Right now, UConn executing on the offensive end. I just think man-to-man is going to be the strong suit for Jim Boeheim, but I think he's trying to steal some time, quite frankly. Maybe rebound out of this, hope that they stop shooting well.
Conrad McRae picks up his first personal foul. Donnie Marshall, 33, is in the game for Danielle Marshall, who goes to the bench. And a little gingerly, I might add. There's Kevin Ollie, came off the bench out of Crenshaw in Los Angeles, the freshman. This is the first of two.
Unsure of himself, Marshall, though. And, you know, before the game, when we asked him how he was, he said that, you know, I shook the hand, I'm not that good. I think when you're not confident in your leg, it's probably a good decision not to perform.
8-for-13 on the season in Big East as he misses both of those at the free throw line. Johnson.
Look at this rebound. He made a nice play.
Great bounce to McRae, and he got fouled. And Donnie Marshall.
Moten trying to throw it off the leg, ends up with almost an assist as McRae goes to the foul line. He is smooth. Just floats around, full control, great with the bounce. And I just think we're going to have to open up the middle and let these three excellent performers, Moten, Autry, and Johnson, dribble drive, see if they can pinch and contain.
We haven't seen Dave Johnson, their leading scorer, light it up yet. McRae will go to the line.
He'll move out. If he doesn't get it in the box, Gary,
he'll find it, right?
He'll slide out and say, let somebody else post up.
Which is exactly what he should do, because he's such a good outside shooter. See the numbers on McRae from the floor and from the line. And he makes one out of two. UConn's had the lead throughout here. 24-20, 8:48 to go in this first half from the dome, the Carrier Dome here on the campus of Syracuse, with a huge crowd on hand here again tonight. Ollie. Kevin Ollie, the freshman, is working the point right now, with Smith having moved down to the side. Ollie.
So they're causing decisions now. Now, if Burrell would look baseline, he had Sellers. He's trying to make two play one, and here's a little post-up play. Not a good pass as McRae gets the bump.
Good defense right there. Big Monday right here on ESPN. First of our triple header here tonight. We're at the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York, on the campus. As we said, Gary Thorne, Bill Rafter, and Mr. Autry's underneath. Knocked for two. McRae would have had it, but it got knocked away. Play underneath by Sellers, who batted it up in the air. Smith for three. Sellers the tap. Walker had it, knocked out of his hands.
That will tire them out, won't it? They're getting those two people on the glass, Gary.
That's a lot of work.
It is.
Rebounding is work.
At the end of the game, it should tire Syracuse out. And, you know, he's not used to having that brace on, although it was bruised in high school, they told us. And that's what they feel is a bruised knee, fortunately.
That's why they think it's not as serious.
I saw Connie Hawkins in Phoenix as Burrell flashes, and that's been open. Too easy.
That's an easy shot for Burrell. Scott Burrell, the junior, and Connecticut's up by six again. Autry. Edwards. Edwards come off the bench. That's for three, and that's high off by Johnson. Sellers and Walker both had it, but it was knocked away by Lawrence Moten. And Connecticut will get the basketball back. When we come back, 7:33 remaining in our first half with the Huskies up. Syracuse has not lost a game here in the last 19. The last loss here was against Villanova last January.
And there's a youngster we're going to be talking a lot about. He's hurt his knee. And as I mentioned, I was in Phoenix, and Connie Hawkins, the new Hall of Famer, he's up there with the premier shot blockers. And the Hawk, I had mentioned last week that Marshall compared, at least made me think of the Hawk. So the Hawk said to me, come here. Talk to me about this Marshall kid. I said, Hawk, he's not like you offensively yet, but he's got some of your ability.
Well, he has put on a show this season, blocking shots and getting the basketball underneath. That's for three. And we continue to pump him up. Burrell missing that one. Syracuse running. Dave Johnson. Johnson, great move, and that's goaltending.
Didn't have to.
By Sellers.
Didn't have to, I don't think, Gary. I think that was going in. You get the feeling Jimmy Boeheim is stealing time, hanging in with the zone. I thought Scott Burrell, trying to win it by himself, the quick three leading to the break, and Syracuse will get more than their share if you make mistakes with the fast break.
They've cut it down to four now. UConn, again, has led throughout the first half here, but I think you're right. Jim Boeheim is borrowing time here, just trying to slow Connecticut down, force the play. Burrell, just like that. Threw it away along the line. Last touch by Syracuse. Yes, it'll stay.
Secunda shouldn't have run after it. Jimmy up and after him. And you talk about doing a great job, huh? Year in and year out. And you think of it, do you think he's doing a better job this year than any other year? You know, you don't get better or smarter. So he must have been doing something pretty good when he had Durek to finish first and to win with this club, a chance to be tied after this evening.
Brian Fair has just come up with his 16th point of the basketball game and his fourth three-point shot. Underneath, McRae will not count. He was fouled before the shot by Torino Walker.
What a great play by Autry. Got the ball centered. Now the defense has to face the ball, and you get the opportunity to give it up. Torino at that disadvantage because of good penetration by Autry.
Brian Fair, the leading scorer in the game with 15 points. Moten has picked up seven. Leading Syracuse. Connecticut up 28-22 with 6:18 to go here in the half. And they're looking underneath McRae, and he gets held again as Rod Sellers was on him, pushing away. Coming up here on Big Monday, 91% free throw shooter. It's all coming up here on Big Monday on ESPN. They're looking to cut underneath. McRae, Autry, Secunda's in there now. We haven't seen him. Glenn Secunda, big 6'8 freshman.
Seton Hall doesn't like to see him. Made that big goal late to win it.
Nice dish and a great turnaround.
Once again, Autry, when they bounce, they're pretty good. It's going to put a little pressure on the defense of UConn.
Rodman McRae has 8 points in the basketball game. He's got Syracuse back to within four.
Flash post tied on the baseline. What they have to do on the wing is bring the ball to the elbow, make two guys play you, and then dump. Now roll the post.
Find Burrell with coverage up deep. And he got him up in the air, and then draws the foul. There's the old up and down. You can't stay on the floor no matter how much you want to. Right. Fair got the defender up, and he'll go to the line.
It's so tempting to pump fake. Makes you king, And of course, the giveaway late, we mentioned his two sports ability. USC, Miami, and Notre Dame wanted him for football, folks.
Len Secunda committing the personal foul, be his first. There's Fair. Smith, looking for the cut, finds Burrell.
Wide open, Jimmy Calhoun not sleeping over there. They've been getting some good opportunities in the three after they've run their offense.
Connecticut putting the pressure on. Dave Johnson still in backcourt to Autry, who gets it in. Autry, outstanding three-point shooter.
Things are a little more congested right now.
Lawrence Moten has the touch. Sellers, who has the rebound. He'll go for the break. Scott Burrell and Autry, a little mano a mano, and it's won by Scotty Burrell.
And did you see Fair trying to help Burrell by sprinting? And a good non-call as well.
Fair has just made himself a starter.
You beat Danielle, he's history?
No. Secunda off to Autry. You love a guy like that coming off the bench. Autry for three. Yep.
Gotta play him. That's the step forward for Red Autry. The outside shot to complement his bouncing ability.
He's two for three from three-point land. He has 8 points. Back under to Sellers. And he's got the two.
UConn bucket by Rob Sellers.
Sellers has 1,000 points in his career with that bucket.
Congratulations.
He is the 22nd UConn to reach that level. Congratulations to him.
He may get 2,000 the way the zone has given up easy baskets. Goodness. Non-aggression pack.
Rod Sellers. And underneath, a foul. Walker, Sellers are both there. Walker will be called on it. As UConn's having some trouble right now defending underneath. As Syracuse gets the basketball under there, they're committing fouls.
Now, Glenn Secunda, you mentioned, well, there's a timeout. Had a great game against Providence, then played decently against the Hall, getting some more time.
And Boeheim would like to get him in more.
On Marshall, because Fair's making threes. Well, the outside shooting opens up the lane for these types of cuts and success. But right here, Burrell in the open floor as well. He can throw the fastball, and he can drive as hard as possible. Nice numbers, and I think it's nice to see him step up after a tough game down in Madison Square Garden.
Danielle Marshall is back in the basketball game. Not starting tonight. He has been in this the second time.
Well, I wouldn't want to play for you, though.
Hey, I'm
one
tough.
Bad hey, game, you're out.
I learned that from you. You don't play well, what have you done for me lately?
Captain Hook. And then they're jamming up the middle and not getting much dribble penetration.
Secunda trying to go underneath.
Very good on the baseline.
He got it there to Moten. Moten.
Look at this.
Got blocked by Burrell from behind. Good play by Burrell, and they control the rebound.
Patience, look at this cross court. They do a great job.
Smith baseline, and he got pushed. Foul will be on Autry, his first.
And they just get you to run full tilt, sprinting to close down, and you're at a disadvantage as the dribbler tries to create.
A lot of coaching going on in this game.
Well, it's an amazing use of all of the light wood, and it makes the defense extend, and close. I think Jimmy's just trying to steal a half. Staying in the 2-3, not challenging. And Jim Calhoun, I don't think he's had easier shots all year, to be honest with you.
Up great to the 1-1, Smith gets the first. A 75% free throw shooter. Chris Smith, number two in the Big East in scoring, averaging 22.7. Alonzo Mourning leading it with 24.4. He gets both of those and has five in the ballgame. Just when Syracuse gets close, Connecticut picks up that lead again, and you see how hot Connecticut is from the floor.
Now the opportunities, they get Fair with the reach in.
Boeheim not happy with that one. And Calhoun now ends up not happy because it's going to go the other way.
Showing a little personality as well. Expressing himself.
It is printable, though.
In passable terms.
Yeah, that's right, in passable terms.
Now, there are a number of guys we know of in the Big East that we have to beep out on occasion.
Yes. There's Secunda, who leaves. Hopkins in. Moten at the line. Moten also now at a 1-1. Averaging 19.1 in Big East play.
Doing a lot for the hosiery business, too,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, he is, too, isn't he? Look at these, will you? This is in Big East history. A chance for Moten to surpass Chris Mullin.
And it's still incredible when he didn't make either of the rookie teams, picked by the mentors. Great insight.
Coaches just did not see him there on the preseason selection for the All-Frosh Big East.
Now man to man.
Syracuse coming out of that zone. Marshall had it knocked away. The battle in the corner for it. Syracuse will come away with it. They've got a two-on-one at the other end. Johnson goes for three. In and out. Rebound knocked away. Nice play, McRae. Good dish, Johnson.
Johnson had the alley-oop, but he knew that McRae had weak side rebounding position and tried to nail him with the three.
Now can Connecticut get a big basket and quiet this crowd? At that time by Burrell, and McRae was fouled.
Hopkins had a hold on as Sellers was in pretty good position. Jimmy used to be a moaner, one of those guys that used to beg. Of course, when you have a start like he's had, you sort of relax a little bit, huh?
When you're off to the 15-3, 7-3 mark, the team that was picked to finish sixth in Big East play and nowhere in the top 25 by anybody, and they're ranked 13th.
You think it changes your personality, huh?
Well, yeah.
I would never know.
You tend to feel pretty good about it. He's got to hang on to it. Marshall.
Foul, I think. Over the top.
Danielle Marshall.
Hey, Jim,
second.
You watch Calhoun. He wants the same call at the other end. Well, a lot of conversations go on. Who would want a referee when you think of it? I mean, you've got a few barristers on the sideline. The quick hitting type of game. And John Clockerty, this is a good group, though. Good composure. They can handle it all.
One and one, each team shooting it with 2:23 to go in the first half. Johnson misses it. Moten.
Amazing. And it doesn't get up as high as a lot of people. Great timing.
Oh, great layup. Johnson avoided the charge by laying it up over two defenders.
A lean in.
Burrell, baseline, wants the bucket. Nice. Dish. So, McRae blasted it away, but a foul before on Mike Hopkins.
Conrad, in talking to Dave Johnson before the game, I said, if he gets some low post play, you'll be really a terrific team. He said, you know, with Conrad now, in practice, we keep looking over our shoulder because that's what he's doing, exactly negating attempts. Now he's got to step it up on the offensive end.
In the act, he will get two. 36-33, UConn leading. Sellers trying to add to it and does. He is an outstanding free throw shooter, 81% from the free throw line. This Connecticut team from the free throw line is fifth in the league at 69%, both Syracuse and UConn, almost exactly the same numbers from the free throw line.
Now they've strictly gone 2-2-1. I was thinking they might throw a full court, all out pressure.
Hopkins, the distance, gets charging foul called against him. And we may have two different fouls called here. I think one official called a holding.
I think John got a reach in on the dribble before the charge.
And I think that's a good call.
And Jim Calhoun saying mercy, mercy. But it was earlier than Hopkins left and exploded. Burrell. And right there, and not a bad call either. Scotty Burrell had the grab.
Burrell is his second personal foul. Hopkins will go to the line. 38-33, exactly 2 minutes left to go.
That's pretty good officiating. Go Egos.
That's right.
Get it right.
There's Burrell picking up his second.
And he gets it right often for this club. I'm impressed with Scott tonight because they were down a devastating loss. I mean, it really creates an emotional situation for a club, and I'm an expert on that. Yet, Jimmy worked them hard, reached them, and Burrell trying to step for wow, what a tough one.
Three! Smith just brought it down and put it up. 41-34. He has 8 points in the basketball game. Chris Smith.
Forget emotion. That was talent. I mean, you don't even have your defensive stance set when he's nailing it.
Do have composure in this Connecticut team. Hopkins.
Gonna have the ball fake.
Johnson.
A hurry.
He was guarded that time. It will be Connecticut basketball. Good, solid defense.
Danielle. for. He could load him up with those long arms. You can do all your inside moves. He's going to take care of business down there.
Lonnell Marshall, 13th in the nation in blocking shots. Alonzo Mourning is first in the nation in blocking shots, both for the Big East, of course. Knocked away, but held onto by Marshall. Danielle, the lazy hook.
Nice look by Smith, too. Syracuse a little soft inside, huh? Not even three-quarter, he's staying behind.
And just a minute ago, it was a three-point game. It's now 43-34. Johnson fakes, got fouled. Danielle Marshall again underneath.
Yeah, that's one of the few times you see him leave early over to help and assist his teammate. But the pump fake outside by Johnson. When you can shoot, those things happen. But his assignment is McCray, and he went up just prematurely, but still got a lot of the basketball, didn't he?
That'll be his third personal foul. He almost got away with it. Mm-hmm. Free throw shooting. Connecticut with the better of it. Johnson will add to it, though, for Syracuse. 1 minute left to go here in the half. John Saunders, Jim Valvano standing by. They will bring us up to date on what's going on in other basketball games around the country. And a look at this game by Jimmy.
Those two guys have to learn to relax in the studio.
Like you.
Take things seriously. People go for a little press after the goal. Nothing. I just don't want to ignite.
43-36, you got them both. 1 minute left in the half.
And here's that step up. They jump out in the trap. Look at this dribble through to negate it.
Fair. Good defensive play underneath. Sellers put the rebound in.
Great job breaking that pressure. Preparation does it.
Their leading rebounder, Rod Sellers, averaging over 8 rebounds a game. And he's pumped that lead up. 45-36. 30,000 plus quiet folks dressed in orange right now.
Now, Autry likes to get it back and beat his guy late.
They're going to hold it here, 23 in the shot clock, and they can run it down to the finish.
I was intrigued. They really didn't do the 3-2 and dribble by people. You may see more of that in the second half.
They're waiting for the last shot here.
Switch to the zone, 2-3.
Hawkins
forces a jumper.
Johnson for three. No. Tap up. Loose. Control by Burrell. And that's going to do it. A big first half for Calhoun's Huskies from Connecticut. Led by Brian Fair in his first start. 15 points. Dave Johnson leading Syracuse with 12. UConn up 45-36. John Saunders.
All right, Gary and Bill, 9-point lead for the Huskies as they try and rebound from that devastating loss at St. John's in the battle for first place. Stay with us when we come back. Scores and highlights and Jim Valvano's pet peeves. You won't want to miss it.
Take a look at, watch Coach Jim Boeheim. Watch his arm. Watch his right arm. What he's saying is, let's go against the press. One of the problems Syracuse has had is they haven't really attacked this matchup press. See, Connecticut's matched up. They're not looking to steal the ball as much as they're looking to slow Syracuse up. And slow them up they did. There's another turnover. And that's what's happened. Coach Boeheim is saying, we got to attack the press. And Syracuse has been a little tentative. And sometimes when you don't score against pressure, it allows the team to continue to press.
As a result, Syracuse is down by 9 points at halftime at home in front of 33,000 at the Carrier Dome. Let's continue now with some scores.
Thank you very much, and welcome back here to the Carrier Dome. Syracuse, they haven't lost here in 19, including 11 in Big East. They're behind, starting the second half.
I thought they were passive. I think they're going to have to be more aggressive. Go out and play some man-to-man against this UConn club. See if that can stimulate them a little bit.
UConn did some shooting from the outside that opened things up for them, Ralph.
Well, Jimmy talked about the three-point shot, and I think when you look here, what has happened, they've come out and tried to tag their three-point shooters, and then, wisely, Jimmy Calhoun, and they did this against Villanova from the top. The cutting Scott Burrell will open things up. That's why I think they have to go play some man-to-man. And just look what the three-point shooting did. The jump shots inside. We saw Marshall with a rolling hook. You saw Sellers with some turnaround jump shots, some follow-ups. So they've destroyed the inside game, and I attribute that to the ability to shoot deep.
Leading scorer in this game is Brian Fair. He picked up a big 15 points in his first start for the Connecticut Huskies. 10 in the game for Sellers, 8 for Burrell, 8 for Smith, 4 for Marshall. Dave Johnson has 12. He's leading Syracuse. 9 for Lawrence Moten, 8 for Adrian Autry, 4 for Hopkins, 3 for McRae. Syracuse 3 for 13 from three-point range. Nowhere near what their season average is. 25% of Syracuse points this season have come from three-point range. They need to get that one going. Johnson was reaching in, and he's called on it. There you see the numbers. The field goal percentage, UConn had it, Syracuse didn't. Free throws about even. Three-pointers, not even at all. Turnovers and in the paint.
The difference. And an old-fashioned weave by UConn before that foul. And the 2-3 zone on the out-of-bounds. You may look either for the three or the flash.
Nice. Walker's play. All alone.
Nice play. He is great going down the middle.
Smith with a great pass. And Torino Walker puts it in, 47-36. In the first half, the rebounding went to Connecticut, 19-15. Not unusual for Connecticut to be able to do that, especially against the Syracuse team that is overall a little smaller.
Nice job sealing.
Hopkins three. Seahawk with three fouls is in there, number 24 for Syracuse. He didn't get much playing time in the first half. Burrell all the way in, and he draws.
Yep, he did. He's Seahawk pretty good at stepping in and out of control once you leave your feet.
That's the way we go in here with this foul. Yeah, offensive foul. Right. That's three on him.
Staying on the floor, key.
Johnson, pressure put on, fair, working the press in backcourt. Moten to Autry, Hopkins.
They're doing a nice job jamming up the dribble drive.
Autry, Moten, good work on Sellers. Sellers bumped him, I think, as he went off the floor.
He's got a great feel on the baseline. I mean, that's something that you learn from continually playing. Look at this. I mean, he almost was out of bounds. The ability to bounce by guys, the timing, and the draw. And you like to make contact.
Move right into it.
He did. Sort of
really created the foul.
That body in.
He goes straight up. He doesn't have a shot, and there's no foul.
It's blocked.
Moten makes it from the line. You see his average and his points for this outstanding freshman. He was 3-for-10 from the floor in the first half and 1-for-5 from the line. He's picked up a couple here, so he's now 3-for-7 from the foul line.
They need some excitement defensively. There they go, man to man.
Burrell. Not bad pass, well read. Hopkins stole it, takes it in. Rebound, Johnson.
That's why you run the floor. Hopkins with a great job warding off, unable to complete.
47-40 now. Well within striking distance. Walker.
Nice job by Seahawk inside. Look at him switching, fronting. And they're trying to dump down to Sellers. He's exhausted. That big wide body banging him.
That's Burrell being guarded by Lawrence Moten. Fair. Can he keep up that first half scoring pace? Goes underneath and they lose it again. Seahawk had it, lost it out of bounds.
Well, Dave did everything right, but squeezed the apple. And down earlier, Hopkins stepping in the passing lane. Just can't get it over to the left and then the completion. But you run the floor, you'll benefit on occasion.
Johnson will pick up the rebound. He leads them in scoring, rebounds, and three-point plays. That's a turnover. And Connecticut's getting themselves in trouble now as they're turning it over. And you see Calhoun saying, easy, guys, easy. This is Syracuse kind of game. Start committing these turnovers, and suddenly they're right back in it. That's what they did in their last outing. They came from behind to defeat St. John's in a great, Seton Hall, rather, in a great basketball game, won it by three. And that'll be knocked out of bounds by Burrell.
You notice Connecticut goes right down on that baseline, seals it off, and the vision impaired as Moten tries to find somebody.
Autry.
Aggressive job. They like the denied rebounds pass.
Moten lost it. Burrell couldn't control. Johnson on the pickup. Hopkins. Basket right here. Hopkins had it knocked away by Fair, who's on him. Burrell coming out top on Sion.
They're just stepping it up a little bit, UConn.
Six on the shot. That's Johnson for three. That's the one.
Well designed play. Fumble it for 28.
Three-point man shoots for three. Smith and a whistle and a pushing off foul is called. And that'll be on Adrian Autry, his second personal foul.
Well, that will stop your aggressive defense when you do a heck of a job for 40-plus and Johnson backs it out. is Jimmy trying to step it up a little, I think.
Johnson, their big shooter, getting him back into this thing. Underneath Sellers, and he got fouled, and that's going to be four on Sion. Six before you're out in Big East play. Wasn't happy with some of the calls fouled in the first half, and he's not happy with that one. He wants to stay in the basketball game.
Thought he got robbed in that first half, hollering over at us. And Coach Thorne said, Marshall should not start for UConn. I'm sure Calhoun will love to hear that.
Sellers. We saw Donnell Marshall coming off the bench.
You're easily impressed. I mean, Fair goes out, lights it up a little bit. We got a couple of games to watch him before you make that judgment.
Okay. 48-43. Sellers' numbers, he's there for his season average and goes over it with that free throw. He's got 12 in the basketball game. Hopkins, Sellers on the press.
They tried to step it up a little bit. They have not gotten, as Jimmy mentioned, that full aggressive. It's a passive. Nice defense.
Bear knocks it away and out of bounds.
We'll hear that
name
a lot.
That's F-A-I-R. What a job he's done, though.
This is where they love to deny and force a turnover. Get a five-second call, but they haven't been as good at it as I've seen them in the past.
Hopkins and Johnson and Adrian Autry. All three can shoot from outside. Sayoc working underneath. Moten, the fifth player, swinging right there between down low and up to the top of the key.
Great matchup, Burrell and Moten. Because Burrell always sneaking a peek, looking to play passing lanes, looking to help.
Two. Autry misses. Sayoc had it and lost it. Donnell Marshall. Sellers. And it's a charging foul on Donnell Marshall, who made the pass out of control. He's got four.
Now, this club is attuned to seeing and reading, and this is one of the better ones. Scotty Burrell always peeking off the ball, turning the head on occasion, forgetting his man. But that's why they're so tough. I'd like to see them, Syracuse, get their guy as far away, Burrell's guy, so he can't assist and create havoc.
Let's see if they do any of that here. Hopkins, Syracuse a chance to cut into the six-point lead now. Connecticut has led throughout. Lawrence Moten. Good defensive play and rebounding by Donnell Marshall, and he coughed it up. Hopkins had the steal. They're going underneath. Rolled around and out. Well, there was no shooting room there for Moten.
Uh-oh.
Burrell, great feed.
Autry thought he could run under it. Burrell can get him up and down. Chris Smith, you don't talk too much about his passing, but a great selection there. The loop.
Smith leads the club in assists coming into this game, and he gets another one right there, and another big basket for Scotty Burrell. How many times have we said that in the games we've seen Connecticut play? Autry underneath, he's got the three.
They have not taken advantage, I don't think, of the middle, and they're all pretty good at bouncing through there.
51-45, the crowd. Into that applause, Smith. Burrell. Fair. Oh, and he got bad foul. Hopkins just came up in the air behind him and had nowhere to go but down on top of him. So Hopkins draws the personal foul, and that's going to be his third foul as Fair was able to draw it. Scotty Burrell, ref.
Sneaks out with the best of them, huh? Pretty good completion.
And they are losing right now to Connecticut, but they are definitely there. They are the top two teams in the Big East. Connecticut still on top, but a loss here. Syracuse would be tied with them. They are also the only two teams in the Big East among the top 25 in the country. The AP poll today, UConn 10, Syracuse 13.
Nice job by Syracuse, shaking it up a little on the D.
Sellers, smoking the rebound. This is Syracuse's chance to make the run. Syracuse 3-for-8 from the floor this half. UConn 2-for-3. Moten, three!
And they made Burrell pay for not getting back in position on Moten.
Now the New Hampton Prep in D.C., Lawrence Moten, and they're back. He's got 14 in the game. Raph, you were so right. Boeheim was buying time in the first half for this right here. Marino Walker, Sellers.
Too big.
Walker, three shots blocked underneath by Johnson, but Fair gets the rebound.
Too many opportunities.
Fair threw it wildly. Sellers, who's been in there about 18 seconds, and a foul called.
He's saying, Donnie, we're from D.C.
Sorry, Jim, no offensive.
Just too many opportunities, though, Gary. Too many dark shirts on the glass. Syracuse not creating area to go to the basketball.
Two on Moten. McRae checks back into the basketball game for the Orange men. And Calhoun trying to fire him up. Zayak has gone out with four.
I tell you, Conrad can fire them up, too, with a couple of blocked shots and maybe some low post play.
A very good free throw shooter, 81%. 52-48, UConn on top.
I saw his brother got into coaching, and I thought he knew better.
You're right.
Central State, Central Connecticut State, I should say.
He is seventh in the Big East in free throw shooting, and he goes 1-for-2. Remember, Syracuse is a three-point shooting team.
Dribble drive, their weapon. They have a high low, but usually with Syak in the game.
That's Hopkins. That's Johnson. That's for three.
There's their high low, huh? The three-pointer.
Moten. McRae. Two, and he got fouled. Walker.
Well, Jimmy B, Moten is played by Burrell, which really takes him out of a lot of stealing opportunities, but he's always looking for the ball, forgot to check out, but Boeheim doesn't win all these games by falling asleep over there. Bernie Fine may have to jab him every once in a while, but just inserting McRae at the proper time, and he lights it up with three.
A three-point play for the junior, Conrad McRae. And look at this, for the first time since we started this game, Syracuse is within one of Connecticut. Smith.
Wow.
Huge basket for Smith.
With the kiss in traffic. I mean, he did a great job backing away from the double of McRae. And then with the defender behind him, dipping forward.
12 picked up by Chris Smith in the game. Moten goes under to Autry. Autry's got the advantage underneath there with Smith on him. Nice. Smith stuffed him.
Real nice job.
Autry. Rebound underneath by Moten.
They have really jammed up the middle. They haven't been able to turn the corner with the bounce.
Crowd quiets again. And we've got a foul on the drive. Burrell is called. He's got four.
Scotty, a little tired with that reach. Normally gets the feet spaced properly.
54-51. Watch the time left. 12:50 here in the second half. Moten on John Young. Yes. Marshall.
That's the ability they possess. Nice pop to the post. Connecticut not as aggressive in denying that high post pass.
And again, Syracuse draws within one. They have not led in this game. And a reach-in foul, and was that ever close? Conrad McRae gets his second, came over the top.
Conrad in great denial position. Do you recall in the first half, we were chatting about the passive low post they were standing behind. That time, he gets punished for being aggressive and in the right spot.
But he fires a club up, doesn't he?
He does. I mean,
he comes
ignites.
Off and gives you that spark.
Now, they've got a spark going. They zone you out of bounds. This sometimes slows your pace down. Gives them a chance to get their legs to bearing.
Smith, Burrell, waiting for the three. Burrell, oh, my gosh.
Not to say much about the open jumpers.
This kid can hit big shots in the game like very few. He's got 13 in the basketball game, but he always seems to pick up the bucket that's needed. Well, a crucial point in the game.
He also knows he's not going out. That's how you build your confidence, too.
Yeah, he knows that. 57-53, UConn maintaining the lead. Moten cutting, fall away.
Very nice. Scotty Burrell normally denying and helping. That time, not denying and sneaking a peek, gets lost on that cut.
Moten's got 17 points, too shy of the season average thus far. The spectacular freshman, Smith in, and he gets the foul. A singular effort. They cleared for him, and he went on the weak side.
You mentioned Burrell stepping up. Smith with great dribble movement. He just knows he's going to get fouled. He just wants to get it up on the glass and step to the foul line, but he defused the double up with his ability to bounce.
McRae has three personal fouls, a two-point lead for UConn. Smith at the line, 75% free throw shooter.
Yeah, you're always curious to hear what others think, and Tate George and Glazin Petrovic play for the New Jersey Nets, and both of them were talking to me on their recent trip about Chris Smith and his ability to change hands.
All right, one shot, guys.
What they think of his ability in the NBA. They feel he's a sure shot.
Really?
Well, they just think he can create so much for himself, and yet we have seen him throw some great passes on the break.
Yeah, he picked up a lot of assists this year.
And he gets both of them from the line. Big baskets right there with 11:35 left to go. Syracuse is drawn to within one a couple of times. Connecticut's put it back to four.
You got to have your head in the game, and you can just see Scotty Burrell continually sneaking a peek. They run a little brush screen, and he gets caught and is very disappointed. He's so used to helping others. They say when you're playing a guy off the ball, see between the man and the ball. But he's always sniffing around to come up with a steal, and poetry in motion.
I love that, don't you?
Huh? Taught him a lesson, huh?
I love that. They got the big sign up here. Lawrence, poetry in motion.
Well,
Johnny Tillotson back in 61. Poetry.
All right,
here we go.
Say that to later, right?
That's Sellers, who was reaching in that time. Sellers will draw his third personal foul. Just wanted Chris Berman to know that there are others out here who draw good signs too, don't they? Huh?
Well, not necessarily good singers, but there are others who know the words.
Oh, we didn't come up with it. It's the fans here. They've got the poster up here. Connecticut's 4-for-8 from the floor. Well, Syracuse has gone 7-for-15. There it is right there. And Lawrence, poetry.
You like that, huh? Little shot? Well, he will be.
I'll tell you, there'll be a lot.
Some rhythmic phrases before his career is over.
What a freshman.
2-3. Open on the baseline, nice little low high, kind of a look, but the hands up, it's like a block shot.
Danielle Marshall again coming away with a steal. Smith on Moulton again.
Should have had one too.
He 61-55.
Is so attractive going to that goal. Just pulls up soft enough to make the shot.
Always under control.
He is.
He's got 14 points in the basketball game for Smith. 10:42 to go. Hopkins, three. Smith had the rebound and lost it. Moulton was on the floor to pick it up.
And Burrell not able to get a body on him, but he may have gotten away with a walk as well.
Johnson for three. No good. Tipped up in the air.
Nothing here. Maybe not.
Danielle Marshall over the back, and he gets the two. Oh. And the basket will count, and Hopkins, called for the foul, is as much concerned about the basket counting as he is that he was called for the foul. He thought he got him before the shot. That's what he was trying to do.
Gary, there was no break here, but Smith attracted everybody because of his one-on-one ability, and then the slip through. Right here, he's got everybody around him, and the control of the guy who shouldn't start, according to Gary Thorne. Oh, Marshall will be there when it counts. I guess last year, the ACC Championship, Carolina did a number. Duke, I guess he won the NCAA title.
Flip it.
Yeah, exactly.
At the line, Danielle Marshall, 63-55. UConn on top.
And you mentioned BC. How about Jimmy O'Brien's club? Everybody's so happy for that guy in that program. Those kids have really stepped up big. They say it was one of the great games, too, in the league.
And the Fair is going to be charged on the foul. That was a great basketball game.
Unbelievable.
That second on Brian Fair, just a little pushing as he came into forecourt.
A little Woolworth number.
A little.
Little five and nickel dimer.
Going to the line. Big foul shots now. 10:14 remaining. And we are in the one and one situation. This is Adrian Autry, a sophomore. Big bucket there. Free throws will matter. The Syracuse team, Jim Boeheim's club, 3 years in a row, last in free throw shooting. And the 2 years before that, next to last in free throw shooting in Big East. They've jumped it up this season, though, and have done much better from the free throw line.
Just the last game, you wouldn't know that, huh?
No.
They went south.
They're sixth right now in free throw shooting in the Big East. That'll put them up a little higher. 64-57.
Cuse, man-to-man. Little high pick and roll.
Fans want desperately to take the roof off the dome here. Each time they've tried, that guy's hit him.
Wow.
Smith.
Nice save by Marshall. The slapback. That was a stacked set. I'm not so sure they wanted that deep three.
He might get back in my starting lineup now. He's got a chance here. There's Fair. Donyell Marshall setting the pick, gets the ball back. Burrell Secundo is guarding.
Burrell is so active. I mean, Johnson's got a handful. He sprints as he cuts it. This isn't long.
There's a couple of good freshmen. Fair and Moten guarding each other. The break there, a two-on-one. Moten trying to save, does. Good play to Johnson.
He's got to come back before the clock expires. They made it.
He's back in. That's for three. McCray on the floor. Double pump. Donyell Marshall committing the foul.
He worked, Conrad, but he may have initiated contact if Marshall had held his ground. You know, Moten ran after the ball, and Johnson did not follow him. They were very fortunate to get the ball back. But this youngster gives you effort. He may have caught a cold. He was gone outside so long, the long pass. And this is motion.
Secunda, the one with the pass. Connecticut has 11 turnovers, Syracuse 5 now. The turnovers will add up in this one.
Incredible effort, though, but Dave had to get over there and say, I'm here, save it. And they were very fortunate to get the ball back. But Conrad, a guy that has sparked this club.
65% from the line, gets one out of two. And it's 64-58. 6 points for him in the basketball game. Running us late, Barry Thorne, Bill Raftery. UConn has led throughout, and this is the first of three in our Big Monday here on ESPN.
How about those two pretty fair players on one another?
Raftery and Smith.
At the point.
Fair. Good pass underneath. He was out of bounds.
Did you see Conrad migrate to the ball as well?
Sellers was standing out of bounds. Another turnover. And here's another chance for Syracuse. Secunda. Autry for three. Tipped out of bounds, I think, by McRae. He knocked it away, UConn ball. And Boeheim's team battling to remain undefeated here at home.
Well, he got by with one the other night, according to him. He said we have no shot at that against Seton Hall.
And it's 70-67 coming from behind late in the basketball game to do it.
And Seton Hall played a great game according to him and the tape that I saw. Once again, Smith puts that pressure on you defensively.
And Autry commits the personal foul. That's three on Autry.
You ever notice all your sets look good when you have a good player? Because when it doesn't work, he makes it work.
Yeah, takes the one-on-one. And there are some guys from both teams on this floor arguing the call a bit, Adrian Autry. Thought he had him guarded pretty well. That'll put Chris Smith back on the free throw line again. And again, the one and one. This game may well be won or lost right here. The one and one has come so early, halfway through the second half, for both teams. No bonus. Secunda the rebound.
Now, Secunda may get free in this zone for a jump shot at some point. Pretty good. Nice.
Tololo, McRae.
Well, Conrad,
welcome
they've
back.
Been looking for you.
Back to within four.
Great look by Johnson.
Great pass by Johnson. That's Burrell. And again, UConn needs that big bucket. We got a foul underneath.
Secunda with the little leg in the back of Walker trying to push him out from the box.
Glenn Secunda, he is from Parsippany Hills High School in New Jersey, a freshman.
Here's that high-low we mentioned that they like to run against man or zone. Conrad with the release, I'll give him a 10. Great balance on the...
Looked like a bungee jump right there, didn't it?
They really can do some incredible things during the course of it. Over the years, they may have some of the great jams in the history of the Big East.
Walker. They'll get another. They're missing the free throws, though. The bad knee of Donyell Marshall did not start. Has been in the ball game a couple of times, though. 7 points in the game. That knee obviously bothering him. He's got it iced.
He's also got a chance to be a great one.
The junior. One out of two.
Well, that's close to his average, huh?
That's it. Marino Walker from the free throw line. 51% free throw shooter. Just about what he did right there. Good block by Fair. Autry covered it up. Moten, the move, the touch. McRae, and a tap.
No responsibility on the checkouts in the zone. And on, Conrad on fire.
Conrad McRae. That one hit underneath the basket. And Syracuse will get the basketball. Conrad McRae has picked up 9 in the game coming off the bench. Jim Calhoun trying to just keep his team under control now. Their lead is cut to 3.
I think he switched to the man-to-man, which has been their premier defense this evening.
Kunda looking underneath for Johnson. He can go up over Walker, who reached in. And Walker commits the foul.
Any move to the goal, there are bodies colliding. And that's the game that Syracuse is best at, taking it to the tin.
Walker has his second personal foul. And to the free throw line. Or four, I'm sorry. Four personal fouls on Torino Walker. And that will get a substitute in. UConn will bring in Don Cerulic is in, and Walker is out.
Cerulic's a banger. Got some little low post moves. And of course, with McRae, you got to get a body. He's doing a great job.
Johnson will get 2. 18 for Dave Johnson.
Now, Jim Boeheim has it extended the floor. They got sections in their honor here, huh? We had rooms in our honor.
That's right. Got them both.
But they have not gone. Look at the smile, Jimmy B.
Third time in the game. They pulled it within 1. They have not led. Knocked away off Connecticut. Burrell hit it last.
You see what Cerulic did? He caught it and bounced it. Now he's dead. The kickback pass, and this place is alive.
14 turnovers for Connecticut. Autry missing.
A grazer.
Sakuna got hit in the eye.
Yeah, he got a shot in the head.
It's going to be Syracuse basketball, but down on the floor is Glenn Sakuna, who took a finger in the eye.
He doesn't want to come out. And right there, he got scraped just before he went down. In the 3-second line, now they're going to stop play.
They will stop here as he's going to the bench. Kunda's on his way to the bench.
He doesn't want to come out. Finally getting some minutes. Look at that left eye, huh?
Mighty red. And Boeheim doesn't want to take him out.
Played for Richie Fiché up in Parsippany Hills in Connecticut. Usually causes turnovers. Having their problems. Usually cause 19 a game.
Connecticut this season has turned it over 16 times a game. Syracuse has gotten the opposition to turn it over 16 times a game. There's 6:57 left to go in this. Can Syracuse get the lead for the first time in this basketball game? They had it once. That was on the first shot. Autry. Oh. Johnson. The fake. Reverse! They got it!
Fell asleep.
Syracuse leads 66-65. 20 points for Dave Johnson. Cerulic. Tough pressure. Burrell. Double teamed and pushed out of bounds.
Sakunda ran him out of bounds, but that's that double up. And he got away with some hand checking on Smith initially. And that time just couldn't regain position. But who was it but Burrell? Strong to the basket.
They huddle at the free throw line. 3 personal fouls on Glenn Sakunda. Back into the basketball game is Donnie Marshall for Connecticut. Cerulic is out. Syracuse, there's the run that has put them on top, 66-65.
This is so similar to the Seton Hall game, isn't it?
Exactly the same thing.
Same set of circumstances. A little earlier in the second half, though.
Burrell. They are right now hurting from the free throw line.
Jimmy Calhoun talking to his guys. Glenn Miller, who does the scouting. Got to make these.
Ties it up. Syracuse came from a 13-point deficit in the second half of that game against Seton Hall with 7:34 left to go to win it.
I'm sure all these kids go back and study after these games, huh? Did they get in it?
Just drop out here, I think. Moten, Johnson.
Most of them are going back to get your job.
That's right. A 3! Lawrence Moten!
Now there's a guy that sets up his outside shot by his ability to drive.
21 for him, Raph. Smith, yes, again. Syracuse leading by one.
This is takeover time. They're not running very many things. It's just premier players doing it.
Smith has 16 in the game. Moten. Secunda over Marshall, and he got fouled.
Now, he's a confident kid. I watched that Seton Hall game, and I mean, he didn't do a lot of things offensively until late, but he was cutting, passing, very much involved. And as they said, Jimmy said he played great against Providence, so they feel he's got to get stronger, which will get him quicker, and he can contribute.
A lot. Secunda will go to the line, 6'8", 210. In his senior year at Parsippany Hills, he averaged over 30 points a game and 11 rebounds a game and a 43% three-point shooter in high school. This big kid, Glenn Secunda.
Notice how the Jersey guys can play with pain.
His second point. Where are you from? 71-68. Syracuse with the lead. Jim Boeheim winding him up.
2-3.
Smith over McRae. Oh. He got fouled and he makes it.
He just is devastating in the middle against the zone. You've got to match up, play head on head with him. You can't let him have an ability or an opening to go and use a kiss. I mean, this is rather strong. Oh.
And he got hammered.
And what a difference. I'll tell you, I saw Boeheim very enthusiastic in that. I mean, he is after it. He's having a lot of fun with this group.
Well, he should.
Maybe surprising even Jimmy.
Surprising everybody else. Chris Smith. Having a very big night again, and he gets the three-point play, and this game is tied at 71.
You know, good coaching, part of it is letting your good players do some things. And Calhoun, even at Northeastern, always let his good players take over. And, you know, when you have Reggie Lewis, those things happen. Curry Moss, and here with Smith. This is deep.
Secunda, that's the three-point shooter we were talking about at 6'8".
Boeheim just... All right, he's saying.
Look, he's smiling over here. Jimmy just looked over. He realized probably I'm on TV, and he looked over and smiled. Gorrell drops it off.
Well, Mark,
that's for three. Sellers, Smith, that's for three.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
Great basketball. Mark that smile down, though. That may be one for the last 4 or 5 years.
It is tied at 74.
Is Smitty stepping up?
Secunda wanted to go for three and dished it off. Autry for three. McRae,
had
nobody
it.
On him.
Well, they want to get three, no twos.
Johnson, three. Yep.
He hasn't moved as much since he was playing with Dave Bing.
Jimmy's running a fast break himself. For three, Smith, do you believe the shooting?
Oh, this is incredible.
Unbelievable shooting. Chris Smith, 77-77. Secunda.
Get him out.
Burrell got pushed on the rebound. Foul is called on Conrad McRae, his fourth. A great exhibition of long ball shooting here at the Carrier Dome with 3:59 left. The game knotted at 77.
How about the heart on both clubs? Just great, great involvement. And the marquee guys stepping up as big as ever. And both coaches, the looseness to give them the freedom to perform. And that's got them in some difficulty. How about this kid?
Chris Smith, 20. 4 points. Sellers makes the big free throw, and UConn is back on top, 78-77.
They have not gone full court pressure, and I think that's a compliment to the ball handling of Syracuse. They've been in the passive set.
He is not a man you want on the line. He made it. Jimmy Boeheim running the fast break for his Orange men, but they are still down by two. Connecticut's got it right now. Syracuse would tie him with a win. Connecticut up by two, but they got to do it here if Connecticut's going to do it. This is the Carrier Dome where Syracuse owns it. 19 in a row, 13 straight versus ranked teams, 30 out of 31. The only loss, Villanova. That came last January. They've won 11 in a row here against Big East teams. And against Connecticut, they are 34-13 in their history of games played. Connecticut and Syracuse are locked up in a great game. 3:49 left here in the second half.
UConn man-to-man, they face guarded on the inbounds that time. First time they did that all night.
That's McRae, Moten, Autry, Secunda, they're the five out there for Syracuse.
Moten killed his dribble. He could have done some damage on Fair.
Autry will be guarded by Mr. Clutch, Chris Smith. Moten for three, the freshman off the front. Johnson tried to get it away from Burrell, couldn't do it. Big rebound, Scott Burrell.
Well, clear out Smitty.
Why not? He's hot. Sellers.
Nice little
Fair, arrow. Brian Fair gets that.
Great pick by guess who? Chris Smith.
He's going to be involved somehow.
Vinny Johnson used to run that where he came off the pick and would go to the goal for the Pistons.
That's the first point in the second half for Fair. He's got 17 in the game. Johnson.
Looking inside. UConn's done a great job taking away their penetration.
Knocked away. Great chance. Burrell tried. Couldn't get it. That's Secunda for three. Tipped away underneath. We've got a foul, a holding foul on Sellers. Sellers was hanging on to McRae in the rebounding action.
Secunda wide open. Not able to convert it, but soft enough to be followed.
Four on Sellers. Take a look at what we got left in this one. 2:37 on the clock. Timeouts, 3-2, UConn with it. Both are in the bonus. Syracuse with the arrow going their way. And it is far from over. McRae will go to the line on the one and one. One.
Well, if you're playing Chris Smith now, as Adrian Autry is, well, he's got his difficulties. They're going to have to shade towards him, particularly at the top. Make somebody else beat you. He is on fire.
There is Chris Smith standing along the line. So Danielle Walker, Marshall rather, checking back into the game. And he gets both of them. Two from the free throw line. 81-79. UConn leading by two. And Mike Hopkins in.
Then, and he's in to play Smith, too, interestingly enough. Mike, pretty good defender, and they switch on the exchange. First time they've done this full, they got the home run.
They got Danielle Marshall, who got by Adrian Autry. Autry gets back on him. Marshall leaned into him. He walked. Autry gets a big break.
Unfortunately for UConn, the damaged knee created that problem. He couldn't sprint, didn't catch it, wasn't as smooth as he normally is.
Danielle Marshall was all by himself. Look at the lead he had.
And right here, he can't get turned. And he did switch his pivot foot. Good call.
Knocked away by Danielle Marshall. Secunda back in the basketball game. Away to Autry. 16 turnovers for Connecticut. Only five Syracuse. Secunda goes up. And it'll be a charging foul.
Fair stepping in. Secunda, he's fearless.
He just goes to the middle. He knows where the hoop is. And he can shoot three-pointers. They're trying to get these switches in a hurry here as Boeheim wants to get Hopkins in to guard Smith.
Ray Morgan alongside telling Secunda to relax a little bit out there. Once you leave your feet, though, you're doomed.
Hopkins is not going to get into the basketball game in time here. I want to remind you, coming up next on our Big Monday, we've got Kansas State at Kansas. The second of three, you'll be
Walters and Adonis Jordan. Roy Williams. Pretty good. Nice win the other night.
Fair, the first. He's now got 18 in the game. Chris Smith leads all point men with 25. Johnson's got 24 for Syracuse. Fair, his first start, has had a big one. A huge night. He's high on the season. He's got 19 now. It's 83-78. UConn up.
Watch Moten now. Fair doing a nice job. Not afraid to dribble, not afraid to shoot the three.
Autry, a drive on Smith.
Pretty
great dish. McRae had it stripped by Smith. He reached in and stripped it cleanly.
Omnipresent. He's incredible tonight. Very alert. Well, forget the St. John's game. Huh? That's history.
That's history, yeah. That's all gone now.
Great win for Louis, and of course the Hall of Fame to boot.
Moten. Three, Johnson. Johnson trying to get his own rebound here. Moten were there, but it was knocked away by Burrell. Syracuse basketball.
I, Chris, feel like that. I helped Louis get in that Hall of Fame, I might add, with a number of victories. Sweetheart, everybody, a friend and fan. And it'll be a great day for him and for anybody in basketball.
Great Big East. These teams are so evenly matched. Zunda in the lane. Didn't get his man up, Autry. 141 left to go, 83-79, UConn leading. Moten, that's for three. Lawrence Moten off the back. Secunda the hook. Moten the rebound along with Johnson. Puts it in.
Are they cleaning it up on the glass? UConn not sticking their men and pushing them out.
That's 26 points for Dave Johnson. He leads all scorers. 83-81, UConn by two with a minute 15. Sellers. Fair. Smith, they're running it off. Smith on Johnson. Johnson stripped it. Moten out in front. Fair behind him. Moten for two. Ties it up.
They're going to have problems. Okay, Walker helped out. Nice play by Johnson. Denying.
UConn wants a timeout.
Syracuse has been negligent pinching. They weren't getting assistance. This time, Moten in the right spot, wire to wire, with a completion that all guys enjoy. So they stepped it up. Now, Jimmy Boeheim with the decision. Do I go zone or man-to-man? I think they've got to go man-to-man. Tag everybody because of the ability of Smith when he's open to crack the gap on the zone.
And 23 points for Moten now, Raf. Two timeouts left. You see the possession arrow goes to Syracuse. Wow.
What a basketball. Just what you wanted.
Yeah. A tremendous basketball game. UConn has led virtually throughout except for the first basket of the game. Then Syracuse came back here in the start of the second half. And they took a one-point lead twice in the game. Then got it up to three in the second half. Then UConn came back, got the lead up to five. And now Syracuse has come back and tied it.
And in the 2-3 zone. Remember, Smith dribbled by the top two guys. You can get a corner jump shot.
About 10 seconds more on the game clock than on the shot clock. We're looking at the game clock. 20 on the shot clock.
I'd say with about 15 to 13, you got to make a little move. There they go. 15 left. They'd like to pick and roll off of this. You see Marshall out high.
Wow. Smith for three. No. Sellers had it knocked out of his hands. It is Syracuse basketball. Sellers touched it last. They've got timeouts remaining.
Jimmy looks like he wants one.
Calhoun wanted a substitution. Couldn't get it. He'll get it now as Autry brings it into forecourt and takes the timeout. 11.8 in a tie basketball game remaining to go here in regulation. Raf coached me through this.
Well, with you, Calhoun's dilemma now is as he matches up, if they turn the corner, they found people. Nice bounce passes inside to McCray. So he's got to contain on the outside on any dribble penetration. Moten is the guy that likes to create, but the one guy that they seem to go to in all the tapes I've looked to is Autry, letting him be the guy that goes between the legs, turns the corner, finishes or dishes. This surprised me very much. Too deep. You know, you might say too soon. I thought he should have passed. They should have run something to get it back to him or get that baseline situation. Jimmy wants the call. Easy business, huh? No emotional strain.
See him defensing. He was saying, come out and get him, come out and get him. And then when the shot went up, just waited an eternity.
Why would you get into this business?
To have this much fun.
If you remember, Gar, UConn is excellent at preventing the inbound pass. They do a great job. They may come up with a steal.
There's a man who can do it right there, Smith. 11 8/10 remaining, 83-83. Syracuse will have the basketball in forecourt. And they will play it in forecourt into the corner. That's Moten. Fair was on him. That's the three. Moten missed it. Rebound Johnson. 5 seconds left. That's the time remaining in the game. Up, no good. A foul underneath. Walker. And with 3 seconds left.
McCray. Around 64. Took a shot in the lower back. A good look at the basket on the out-of-bound. Moten with his speed able to get over. And here's the skirmish. And, you know, question the shove. Give it to either Sellers or Walker. I mean, he's doing a better job than Konaseka in his heyday. Fred Astaire, no.
3 seconds left to go. A two-shot foul. Boy, there were a couple banging on the floor on that one. You saw McRae go down and Johnson over him. Close games are not unusual.
Now they can put somebody in to shoot, saying that where's Conrad? McRae is hurt. Now Calhoun will complain about it, and this is a tough rule.
You see these two teams last four games decided by 4 points or less.
They put Hopkins in because McRae is injured. And Jim Calhoun, it's frustrating, but that's the rule.
Hopkins is going to go to the free throw line. It would have been McRae going to the line. McRae, a 65% free throw shooter. Hopkins, a 50% free throw shooter.
But known as a shooter when he came in here.
3 seconds left. Game is tied. He'll get two. He comes off the bench to do it.
Well, is that confidence by Boeheim? See, this kid has the ability. He's just struggled. He's been tight, trying to appease Jimmy and the coaches instead of just playing.
Hopkins at the line. Syracuse leading by one. UConn has the opportunity to call a timeout. Hopkins missed it, maybe on purpose.
No. I think the wind got that one. He hit a knockdown shot with a 9-iron. While Michael got the one, three to go. You've got a couple of choices. UConn with one left, correct?
One left.
One timeout. They can go to half court and get the timeout. Maybe not get any, particularly at home, you might not get any time off, but you might just get a tenth off or two at the most, so you've got a chance then to inbound and get some sort of a jump shot that you've worked on. And that's the thing at the end of games. Everything that's being discussed now has been worked on. They're going to run X play. So-and-so's taking it out. There's options on the play to get it to half court if that's what you want. Or bring everybody up. They may look for the home run as well. They've got to get somebody in the five position deep to make sure that there isn't one over anybody's head.
3 seconds left to go. Syracuse leading by one. Hopkins, who put the air ball up.
Well.
Who loves you, baby?
You spent a lot of time together.
Maybe that's why he missed. You take a look here at the standings in the Big East. Connecticut on top. Syracuse trying to put Connecticut in that 7-3 category as well and tie them for first place. Both these teams have Seton Hall coming up next. Syracuse will get them on Tuesday. Connecticut's going to get them on Saturday. And what a basketball game this has been. Syracuse trying to remain 19-0, undefeated at home this season and going back to January of last year. It has not come easy tonight, but they've played it the way they're playing so many of their games this year, and that's keep it close to the end and then win them close.
And surprise, Conrad back in, he feels fine.
Amazing.
See, NBA, you can't come back.
So the injured Conrad McRae is back in the basketball game, and he's all right. The ball played on the side by UConn now. 3 seconds left. They are down by one. They get it in. Trying to draw the foul, Smith. It's going to go out of bounds. This game is over. Syracuse has defeated UConn 84-83. Undefeated at home this season, and there's a tie in the Big East for first. For Bill Raftery and all my crew, this is Gary Thorne. That's our final. Back to John Saunders.
Makes you want to check the videotape replay. Could have, would have.
Was it a foul? Was it a basket? Yeah, well, one of those nights. We learned Saturday that UConn may not be quite as good as many of us thought. They'd been on the edge, winning two games in overtime, you recall, building a fine record before that crash in New York City. Tonight, it was Syracuse, first place at stake. And I thought they played a terrific ball game, even though they did come up that 1 point shy. Brian Fair, first half, a three-pointer, it was 7-3. Here's Fair again. He was absolutely terrific, filling in for Donyell Marshall, who couldn't start because of an injured knee. Marshall did play in this game, however. When Chris Smith would score, it was 17-11, the Huskies by six. Syracuse was hanging around. You're not going to put them away in their own building. 19-15, when Johnson would get the rebound off the missed shot and score. But the story was Fair, 22-15. He had 16 points in the first half, more than an adequate fill-in for someone who couldn't start the game. When Fair scored again, it was 28-22 on a two-pointer. Rod Sellers would score, 45-36. So at the half, a lot of questions were answered already, the main one being that UConn could bounce back and play a basketball game after what happened Saturday at Madison Square Garden. The second half was wild. Secunda scored. Syracuse was back, had a lead by three. Chris Smith answered, 74 all. Johnson at the other end. Syracuse again by three. Chris Smith said, enough of that, 77-77. The Huskies took a four-point lead when Fair went to the basket, laid it up and in. But down the stretch, Chris Smith going to the basket, has the ball stripped. Syracuse with the easy layup. It was 83-83. And then Chris Smith, with time remaining on the shot clock, took a bad shot. He was too far away from the hoop. It wouldn't go. There was a foul at the other end off this sequence. The missed shot, UConn couldn't get the rebound. The foul, Mike Hopkins would go to the free throw line. He had a two-shot foul. He made the first, and that was all Syracuse needed because they would win this game by that basket right there, 84-83. Now we'll join Eric McClendon live in Syracuse, where it's warm and cozy, huh, Eric?
Well, I tell you what, Dave, it's awful cold out here, but it was really cold in the locker room after the game. You know, it's a funny thing. You know, when you become a successful basketball program, the highest highs never seem to meet the lowest lows, and UConn hit a low tonight. You know, you look at the stat sheet here, and it's unbelievable that they even conceivably lost this game. You know, they shot 62% for the game from the floor, 62% for UConn. Syracuse only shooting 39%, but Syracuse took 26 more shots than UConn. Because of the turnover factor, UConn turned it over 17 times. Syracuse turned the ball over just 5 times. And as you can imagine, after the game, there was one very happy coach, and it wasn't Jim Calhoun.
You know, this was a hell of a win. I'll tell you, that was, you know, I haven't seen that many better games in here. This was especially the second half. When we answered and made the three, and they made it, and then we made it, then they made it, and then Chris made a three-point play on the drive. You know, I mean, those were all, you know, I mean, just great plays.
We had this one all the way, you know. We were supposed to win this one, and it just got away from us.
Different kind of feeling after this one, or is it the same kind of feeling as the St. John's? I mean, you lose by 33, and then you lose by one.
During the St. John's game, you know, we lost by. We got kind of embarrassed, and we wanted to come back tonight and just play hard, and most of the things just play hard. And I think we did that, but down the stretch, we didn't get a lot of key rebounds in that. That was unfortunate for us because they went down and capitalized.
We don't feel better. You lose, you know, you always feel bad. No matter how you lose, you're going to feel bad. I thought we should have won this one tonight, and Syracuse played a great game.
One encouraging note coming out.